Baldur's Gate 3 is a game where you can do pretty much anything you want. But do the homies have what it takes to beat the game in the hardest difficulty and unlock the glorious golden dice? In honor mode, you only have one save file, so you can't just save scum your way out of a bad situation.
Wait, it hasn't saved, right?
I mean, it hasn't saved.
Where's our last save at?
Oh, whenever I close the game saves. Besides that, if all of your party members die, the game is over and you lose the run. So, will we be able to tackle this mission? Well, Anthony, Aiden, Kelvin, and I sought to answer this question. This is the Homies Honor Run. In January, I messaged Kelvin on Discord about possibly doing a duo honor run together. I had already beaten the game twice before, and I knew a lot about the story and strategies we could implement. But the only problem was, I kinda suck at D&D. In my previous playthroughs, I played as a barbarian and a paladin, and I would just kinda run in and smack people. I knew little about how to optimize my other party members, and this resulted in me just spamming magic missile on Gale half the time. This is why I recruited Kelvin. Kelvin is a bit of a D&D expert, at least compared to me, and they had a much greater understanding when it came to many of the game mechanics. On the other hand, I knew how to optimize parts of our run from watching YouTube videos and playing through the game multiple times. So, I offered Kelvin a bit of a partnership.
But you know the business, and I know the chemistry.
After Kelvin finally got a new keyboard after breaking it due to Brawlhalla, we both set off on our journey to beat Baldur's Gate's hardest difficulty. Kelvin and I entered the character customization with a somewhat rough idea of what we were going to do. As a player who specializes in running in and smacking people, I decided to be a Githyanki fighter. Not to be confused with Lazelle. Kelvin went through a couple different options in the beginning, but they eventually decided to be a bard for that sweet, sweet charisma stat that would help us out greatly in the future. Thus, Olaf and Exquisitine Biznip were born. The unfortunate thing about Act 1 is that I didn't actually decide I was going to make this video until towards the end of the act, so not much footage of our early adventure actually exists. Not long after Kelvin and I started our playthrough, a new recruit decided to join. Anthony. Anthony decided to play as a ranger, and his character was named Langestine Chargeabug. Anthony specialized in sticking in the background and picking off enemies with his bow. But in the early game, he didn't have too much success. But that would all change later. After going back and forth on if we should save or murder the tieflings, we decided we would try to save them.
Good, like, dude. Month or two.
Oh, she just dies. She dies. She dies.
Fucking, what's his name?
No, she's surprised. We still have a round.
Okay. Mr. Rock.
Wait. Before you... That won't work. Okay, so...
I can use my action surge.
Before you attack, let me see if I can try and... Yeah...
I mean, I'll just simply use my axe so I can take the fuck out of her. Watch this shit.
There's an illicit parasite in that corpse.
You should take a look. Yummy, yummy.
After killing Gut, we positioned Anthony up above to destroy the bridge Minthara walks on, so we could kill her easily.
Oh, yeah, I'm hiding. You can totally do this.
Okay. Oh, wait. I have to fucking bink this? Oh, no. I don't know if I hit this fucking dice roll.
Hit what roll?
Cause she's looking in my mind, and she'll see that the fucking helped kill the fucking goblins.
Wait.
I'm not doing anything, I'm just sitting here.
Who just jumped from us? What the fuck?
I'm coming, Brett! Hang on!
The fuck is going on?
Don't worry about it, you have body inspiration.
I'm so clipping!
Unfortunately, Anthony missed the shot, letting Minthara walk away, free to attack the Grove. At this point, we decided it would just be best if we just helped her slaughter the Grove, which proved to be a slight mistake later on, because we missed out on all of Damon's wonderful loot. It's probably for the best that there is no actual footage of us slaughtering the Grove, because it is not something I can say I'm too proud of. Although Kelvin might say it was worth it, because they got to sweet talk Minthara. After committing this atrocity, Karlak and Will decided to pack their things and leave. And this opened the door for another homie to take their place. Aiden joined the party as a glorious half-orc paladin named Farquaad. Aiden's first experience with the party was a little rocky, as we almost lost the run for the first time while fighting a vicious pack of gnolls. Everyone had been downed, and I had to flee to the safety of camp to revive them all with withers. Speaking of withers, I found out that you could just pickpocket your gold from him over and over again without him getting angry. So that's what Anthony would do whenever we needed reviving. This proved to be a great tip that helped us not waste too much money in the early game. Our next big fight was against the phase spiders, and it was here where we made a grave mistake.
Lump's Warharm?
Yeah, I don't see it either.
Oh, it's in my inventory. How'd it get there?
You had it the whole
time. How many have summoned it? Well, I didn't blow it. I thought Kelvin blew it.
I thought I blew it too. Try it.
Yeah, see if they come down here.
Okay.
I mean, we're not in a fight yet. Shouldn't we get in the fight first?
Nah. They'll trigger the fight for us. Bitch is on a bridge right now. How
do you want to deal with these fucking... Yeah, Aiden has fire.
Okay. Aiden, you have fire.
Oh, they're here.
Oh, they're here. Friends? Pride Month turn up? They just broke our stealth? Fuck. Alright, the moment it gets on top of a bridge, I'm dropping Cloud Dagger.
Okay, you should do it. I don't know how long these guys stay here when they're not in a fight.
Okay, I'm dropping Cloud of Daggers to break a bunch of the things. Just start hitting this thing.
Go. Oh, guys, they're pissed at me.
Why? Oh my god!
What the fuck?
Run. If you don't sound them at the right spot, they come and they're like, where's the meat?
Because we weren't in a fight yet. Oh,
hey,
how
about this?
God.
Whoever, Kelvin, run.
Yes. Going.
At least you broke the eggs.
I'll distract. Oh no.
I don't know, Aiden just fucking sounded it and
I was told it was fine.
By who?
Did Kelvin say something?
I said I thought. I haven't used those. I've made that very clear.
2 seconds.
No, we're not in a fight yet. Shouldn't we get in the fight first?
Nah. They'll trigger the fight for us.
Oh yeah. I prioritize the barrel. But only the hits.
Okay, ready? For science!
Oh, he's prone. Oh, he took so much damage. If you got a pink?
Oh!
He has 11 health, 11 health. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we are Mick chilling.
Yeah.
That's big, man.
That was huge.
Good shit, boys. Anthony, take your shot, brother. Take your shot.
Boink that motherfucker.
And it's my first turn, so I can shoot twice. That's so funny.
Do your thing, 21. Do your thing.
After eventually defeating the spiders, we were able to use some explosives to murder my Githyanki brethren, who were super pissed at us for some reason. And Aiden, Kelvin, and I were able to take down Ethel on our own. Aiden's smites proved to be a bit too strong, so we weren't actually able to get the sweet stat boost that Ethel would have offered us for letting her keep that annoying girl. Aiden got a cool pet named Connor though, so that was nice. We then ventured to the Underdark, where we were able to praise the one true god, Bual.
Oh, blessed Bual!
We did many quests down here trying to get as much XP as possible, one notable being helping Glut take his rightful place as the leader of the colony. Glut tasked us with a mission to kill some loser named Nir in Grimforge, and we sailed out to fulfill his request.
this guy any resistances? God, they just, none of them like poison. Wait, poison isn't acid. Acid will work.
Can you cook them? Hi.
I was gonna say, how does your oath not break when we killed the Grove, but you didn't join us during that.
I wasn't born yet.
Born yet, we were murdering the Grove. That was Karlak.
How did I break the oath by overthrowing the guy?
Wait, what?
What the fuck was that?
What just happened?
You took the psionic damage.
What?
It works on anything.
Well, you'll still...
You're gained so much XP today, this is great.
I will try and...
Same, we're only level 5 still. I feel like we should be still higher.
Yeah. I just want to be level 6 when we go into the creche. Because they're so scary. That's the next, like, very scary thing.
Yeah.
Bro, better ball.
You fuck up the enlarged guy. He's pretty strong.
I can't really fuck him up too hard. Ow. Fuck you. So I was just emoting on him.
So much damage. I can miss it. Oh, I missed.
Ah. You just fucking...
Okay, I get another...
Stop doing this! That was so funny. Nice.
I did like 7 emotes. Miss. Time for mercy.
Anthony, please wait for me to move. I'm just getting. I'm at 11 HP.
Wait, hold on. I got you.
You got one more? Oh, no doubt, brother. No doubt.
That 3 was huge.
All right, I'm gonna see if I can. He has 2 more psionic messages on him.
Wait, you didn't shoot the other one? What happened?
What? I only had 2 shots.
God damn it.
Anthony, can you please wait till I move?
God damn it.
That was so funny.
I can't even shoot him! Fuck!
You tell him, just gotta trust my intuition, dude.
Did you shoot Aiden?
I did!
That's crazy.
Wow.
Why is that an option?
Oh, Nier is so low.
If I get psychically exploded again, I'm gonna fucking lose it.
Bro, if Anthony shot him instead of fucking Aiden.
I'm gonna fucking lose it. I'm so tired of this shit. There wasn't even direct damage happening to him. It was just AoE. And this motherfucker chose. I'm so tired.
We were able to save our good friend Barkus, who we had decided not to send flying away earlier in the story. Aiden and I really wanted the adamantine armor from the forge, so we headed deeper into the forge to face off against our first true boss of the game.
Is he a construct or is he a...
I have a plan, Kelvin. We'll see if it works, but I have a plan. And that plan involves Anthony being a little bitch boy.
We don't need to smash him on the head.
Boo-hoo, bro. I don't want to die. So, all you do is hide behind us anyway. Me and Aiden, we be getting killed.
My first fight, I died.
He also has a legendary action that will fuck us up, so...
Why are we being pussies?
Wait, you want to fight him like a man?
I don't want all of us down there in the fucking lava with no chance of escape whatsoever. You and Kelvin stand over here, okay? Stand like right where I'm standing over here.
Yippee! I think lava is in that little lower part, though.
Anthony, would you be able to hit him from up there?
I think so.
You have arrows of exploding thunder, right?
You should stand next to each other, because I'm going to hit the lever, and I'm going to misty step, like, right here to get him to fucking come to the forge, and then one of you is going to have to hit the fucking lever, and on the same turn, Aiden, you're going to use your misty step, and you're going to misty step over to hit the fucking lava. Can you hit the forge lever with your
you can shoot
bow
it
from here?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Okay, that is also huge. Okay.
I want to move.
Hmm?
Oh. It's funny, I'm just not in this combat right now.
That cat is dead as hell.
My cat. Oh no, it's immune to fire damage!
Oh. Wait.
It's immune to...
I guess it isn't a physical...
You want me to shoot this guy or what?
450 damage. Sorry, health is crazy.
Oh, what the fuck? I walked into lava. I love how it just lets you walk on lava. Okay. I died, that's okay. Okay, he's in prime position. I don't know if it'll hit me. Maybe you don't slam it now.
You'll get a chance to stand, I think.
I'm saying I don't know if I'll get hit by the hammer. You think I'll get hit by the hammer?
Oh, 100%. No doubt in my mind.
Let me move. I'm gonna move over to the valve, and then you're going to hit the hammer.
Okay.
Hit the hammer.
This lever here?
Yes.
Okay. Oh! I don't like that I'm its threat assessment. Does he get hit by this?
I think he should.
Yeah, he definitely will.
Okay. That shit, Kozo. Oh. Nice. Yeah, there's the little dudes. Anthony, we got something for you to do while, I don't think...
It's just gotta... We gotta get him back into it.
Oh, hey, buddy. Oh, God. 1 HP, baby! Oh, wait!
Whoa.
Oh! Okay, that's fine. Methods.
I could shoot at him.
Yeah.
Yeah, shoot at him. Try to become the primary target so he, like, kind of walks over. Should I Misty Step on the thing to try to get him back over here?
I think he's currently on Aiden. I think he's going to go.
Well, he'll do it this way anyway.
I'm
just gonna do it
and rush.
Let's get him.
Why did that guy hit him?
Wait, no way.
Method tossed. Wait.
I mean, oh wait.
Going
oh.
Okay.
Yeah, Brett is gonna. That guy might have just.
Wait, but I'm not in this plane. He can't damage me.
Caps.
I can become the sacrificial lamb here.
We got two of them already primed up right here, so.
Oh. Okay.
I'll take care of this one for the team, boys.
Pop, pop. We'll see you on the other side.
I love the game's movement. Yeah, it's crazy.
Exquisite scene. I need you, bro. I would have died if I didn't have fire resistance. That's crazy.
It is so funny.
I'm actually bored of this.
Please,
man. It's
fine.
It was not enough. Oh, wait, because Relentless Endurance.
Yes, he's on the thing. That's fine.
Sorry,
Aiden.
Sorry,
Aiden. Dying this turn, but it's okay. Kelvin, you're dead.
I'm down.
I got it.
Okay, you can hit him.
I'm so dead. Like, wait, that didn't hurt me.
45.
Right.
It certainly did.
Could you get to Kelvin and get them up? And then Kelvin... Do you have a bonus action still?
Yes.
Can you get me up with that?
Let me see.
This will be like half a minute. I feel like he'll just get up, step in it, hit me, and then stay in the same spot. It could be big brain. I'm just gonna go over here for now.
I could probably push him.
I'm gonna shoot him. Just to bait him. Wait, I guess I just got up. I can't shoot. Fuck. If Anthony shoots him, he might get mad at him.
Oh, no, I didn't go into the fucking ethereal plane.
He's gonna be mad at Anthony, which he just cannot hit him.
Okay, well, it didn't pull his attention anyways.
Why'd you put on Anthony?
I didn't.
No, Anthony why did you shoot again, Anthony?
Oh, I don't know.
And he'll walk in the lap.
I lost point.
Get in there, buddy. Get in there. Don't go too far. Oh, he got so far.
Dipping his toes.
Hey. It's okay. Nah, it's fine. I wanted to die this way. One of you get over there and shoot him.
There goes my hero.
Perfect. Oh, don't worry, we got Anthony. Anthony, shoot the lever. Shoot the lever, Anthony.
Take the shot.
Should kill him. Yeah!
Let's go. Okay.
Anthony, go back.
Don't die.
Yeah, don't go straight back to camp. I'd say just go straight back to camp right now.
With that, we finally had enough XP to reach level 6. After that, we headed over to try and kill Bernard, but he hit a lot harder than we all expected.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Oh! I'll be back.
I'll be back.
Alright. Bro, I think the plan of attack here is we kill these guys. Fuck them, we leave. You aren't beating me today, buddy. 80%! I hit these!
I mean, might as well fucking hit Bernard if you can.
When I lose, you win! Wait, what? Oh, the gang's here.
Wait, who the fuck is this guy? Where the hell did he come from?
So should I run away, or...?
Oh, I'd think about it.
Come on, bro.
Fuck!
I keep forgetting that's fighting, not paralyzed. I don't got a lot of juice. But I'll give it to you. Ooh, baby!
If he walks at me, I'm gonna lose my shit. That is so funny.
Wait, how the fuck did Kelvin die? I thought I hit him die.
Oh, the leaping static thing fucking triggered.
What's up, little bro? Battle bro?
Very losable fight.
Bye, Anthony. Bye, Anthony. Bye, Anthony.
Oh, he's still here. Try back up.
I could just leave.
Can you? Already?
I could.
Yeah, you should just leave. Well,
what are you gonna do?
I'm trying to finagle a thunder wave.
Oh, he's got 16
Wait.
Health.
It killed me.
Fucked.
Oh, just shoot the shit out of him then. Whatever. Fuck it.
I'm gonna sacrifice.
No shot. There goes my hero.
Wait.
Do not shoot him off rip when he gets back up, because y'all, he will fucking...
Not me.
Okay.
44%?
There it is!
Dropped his weapon. Didn't kill him.
Pick it up.
I'm a little...
Watch this. Bank.
There goes my hero.
Turn! It says if I jump down there, I die.
He's got a key, bro. Antique key. I don't know where that goes.
After another close call, we decided to finally make the trek into the mountain pass. The Githyanki Kresh was something I had been fearing for a while when starting this run, and it was the first thing I thought could be considered a run killer. As a Githyanki, I thought returning home would be fun. But after they tried to fry my brain with some weird machine, I wasn't too fond of them. We thought the best strategy here would be to thin out all of the Githyanki in the building before going to the big fight, so we wouldn't have to deal with any of them later. In doing this, we leveled up to level 7, and it was here where I found the bread and butter of my fighter build. I had taken great weapon fighting as a feat at level 6, and at level 7, I took the precision attack maneuver because they paired really well together. At this point in the game, Aiden and I were both still strictly fighter and paladin, but Anthony and Kelvin had begun multi-classing. Anthony put several levels into rogue for sneak attack, and he was eventually able to deal out massive amounts of damage at the start of his turn. Kelvin dipped into wizard and went full caster mode, because they were the only caster we had on our squad. After talking to the false god of Lakith, we headed into the portal to talk to our dream visitor, before the big fight.
Oh. Okay. Sorry. That's fine with me. And then I'll give Bardic. Yeah, I would rather we go in and you guys have this shit than whatever. So.
Okay. See, I just did get the Yankee jump thing. Does that mean I'm not gonna have a turn when we walk in? Or like, what if we leave turn based mode and re-enter it? Will that like reset our thing?
I think maybe if we do it quick.
That's what I'm saying. Exit turn based mode and fucking put us back in.
Oh. Whoa! Why wouldn't it let me go back in?
I'm fucking just walking in.
Yeah, just go.
Our queen spoke to me. You have failed. Your death has been decreed. Words my queen.
Alright, gang.
Crush Yilik. Yeah, we do not.
We're all lethargic.
It's because the fucking Yeah, that's the downside of using the fucking speed potion is you become lethargic at the end of the three turns.
Like, three turns already end?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Okay.
Nice.
This guy only has 145 health. He has high armor class. The rest of these guys are weak, though. His armor class is 7.
Fuck.
You got two of them guys now.
Okay, Scratch might die for the boys here.
Cool. Yeah, he has his Mind Steal link on the fucking... the method. That's completely
that
fine
Scratch?
With me.
That boy Scratch? Do you want to go for the dude, or do you want to go to the guy in front of us?
Yeah, I can just get to him. Just
after
jump him.
He or his allies struck, you can summon another one. So we'll...
What the? Why am I blinded?
Oh, I shot it before you fucking went over there. It's just not true. I was in the middle of your reaction. Yeah, I did it at the start of the turn.
Just hit, so I don't...
Oh, we're cooking up.
Using all my
precision. Oh, Brad, we're cooking
That's
up.
Just
I'm gonna end him!
Stinny.
I'm using all my fucking dice, but...
Just
precision
do it.
Precision attack, fucking great. Oh, come on, man. How precise do I have to be?
You are blind.
I'm glad you came.
Get out of here!
Now leave before the others come for us.
This is it. Now an easy fight.
Despite our big misstep with the haste potion, the fight went a lot easier than I thought. We hit a devious lick and stole the blood of Lathander from the monastery, and I also made sure to steal the Githyanki egg so that one day I could raise it as my own. And then we finally made our way into Act 2. Act 1 went by better than I thought it would. One of the unsung heroes of Act 1 that I have not mentioned yet was Glomp. By continuously knocking Glomp out, we were able to steal thousands and thousands of gold from him every day, and he didn't seem to care too much. We had some close-death experiences with the gnolls and the spiders, but now that we are decently geared, we hoped Act 2 would be a little less stressful. When journeying to the Shadowcursed Lands, we opted to travel through Grimforge, so we could fight with the Harpers and also get XP from fighting with them again against the Spider Guy later. After defeating the Shadow Demons, we headed over to the Last Light Inn as quickly as possible so we could get protection from the curse. Unfortunately, there were no tieflings alive to vouch for us at the inn, but some random guy named Marcus decided to vouch for us instead. Marcus then tried to talk me into helping him kidnap Isabel, which was a little weird. But after all the evil things our party did in Act 1, we decided we would switch it up and be the good guys this time. I opted to attack Marcus without talking to Isabel first, and I almost thought I made a grave mistake. I ain't gonna fucking fight her.
Oh, I said wait so I could summon in my guy. Fuck, dude.
Okay, I get, okay, just focus him down, I guess. And then I will try and, like, fear lock her or something.
Darkness?
He's not trying to attack her, at least.
Nick, can you just hold person there?
Yeah, I can try.
Where the hell did you come from? Wait, she's here now.
Wait! Yeah, she's our ally now,
don't fuck her up.
Okay, I'm gonna put heroism on her just so that she, like, lives. And then...
I think we're good, bro.
I'm gonna try and, like, Mr. President the fuck out of her, honestly.
Yeah, you gotta, honestly.
Yeah. No,
she gets knocked out. She's fucked.
Come on, Stone the Fawn. How you doing, man? What's going on?
What's up, Caleb?
Oh my god, bro, just ate so much HP.
He's prone.
Oh my god, he's at one health.
That's reverberation, baby!
I just did so much damage to him.
Fucking end this dude's suffering.
Let's get it, Fork! Come on, Fork!
Fork hits these for sure.
I hate hearing the guy singing below us.
Easy XP.
Damn.
Fork is ready to hold that door.
Hold the door, Fork!
I think it's Joe, dude. We got Mr. President guarding him.
They both just dashed, though.
Yeah.
This guy's almost dead. Try to kill this guy.
Which one?
That one.
This
one
left.
In front of me. That's 16 health.
Oh.
After successfully defending Isabel in the inn, we all headed out to kill the weird spider guy so we could steal his lantern.
Oh.
Oh my. The absolutes for my queen. Yeah, fuck that.
Sorry, Fork.
After this, we went around the map getting as much XP as possible.
Okay, that was like all my health, but that was cool.
We made a pit stop at a weird-looking pub, and before we could go send in Kelvin to go talk with the guy, Anthony charged in and took the lead.
Well, I guess it doesn't really matter which one I choose, right?
Huh? Yeah, this is why we wanted Kelvin.
Hmm.
Wait, use the bonuses. Oh my god, he banged it.
That 20.
I think we're not out of the woods yet. There's another one. Do
I ask him the other question or do I sleight of hand?
I'll use the sleight of hand.
Okay. Do you have any inspirations?
We have one.
Oh, you're good.
Another story!
Escalators! Fuck!
Four. Fuck. Alright, I'll roll the take the inspiration.
Yeah, shit. I
do not want to
fight this guy.
I don't even know what to expect from fight from him.
Eels!
Oh my god, we're so cooked.
No more blah, blah.
Okay, we have deception.
Oh, okay.
Give me blood.
Okay.
Or I take it.
18 though. Not good, but. Manage.
Escalators.
Oh,
wait,
maybe.
Please.
It was a 5.
Ah, oh, let's go.
Fucking great.
Oh my god.
Bro, this is so many fucking saves.
This one banks, dude. This one plus 10.
Oh,
we're good. Yeah, I had no fear doing this when I could just load back.
Mm-hmm. He's about to blow up.
Not never.
He died.
Holy fuck.
With Anthony clutching up, we nearly had enough XP to hit level 8, but we decided that we would finally head over to Moonrise Towers to see what all the fuss was about.
And what would you do to...
They are put to...
True. Hold him. Night Warden Mintharai.
No! Yep, seems good to me. While nobody else was around, Kelvin and I walked around the map to get some more XP, and Kelvin was able to convince a creepy doctor and a lady made of gold to both kill themselves, which gave us enough XP to hit level 8. With most of the side quests out of the way, we headed into the Gauntlet of Shaar, and it was here where I had a great strategy. Balthazar needed to be taken out, and there was no way we were going to fight him by the Night Song, where he could easily push us off to our deaths. We could have just fought him straight up where we first encounter him, but I had heard of a way to kill Balthazar without even having to fight him at all. All it would take was an invisibility potion and Kelvin to sneak their way in.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright, jib into this section.
Should I hide first?
Yeah, hide.
Okay. Alright, and then I'm gonna end turn because I have no actions. This turn, I will knock and then invisibility again. Holy shit, legendary action, the dead wastes? What does that mean?
Who has that? Do you see
I don't know, but something behind this door just used it. Bow. Door's unlocked. Wait. Why did it fucking do... Why?
Worst case scenario, you should be able to open the door scavenger. At the start of your turn and then try to get out.
Let me drink this.
We just chill.
Open the door.
Oh, there we go.
Cool.
They get put in combat? I can't even fucking tell.
They did.
They did? Everyone's in combat?
All of them are in combat.
That is fantastic. All right, you can just start making your way back over here then.
Making my way.
Alpazar's anger bears.
Oh, he drank a haste. Just crazy.
Damn, that judge is this year is not living.
Let's get the gang's about to spawn here in a second.
True. Oh my god, yeah, we love that. We love that. Bring them in.
The gang's here. Are you invisible?
Yeah.
Love that from the kid.
Wait, hold on.
Oh my, who is that guy? Why is that guy so big?
He has a circlet of animate bones, and he has a Justiciar Crusader.
Who is that dude? He is terrifying. Holy fuck!
Yes, the radiant retort.
Holy fuck, Balthazar! No!
Balthazar's already. Wait.
What? No, he's not. No, he's not.
Wait.
Look, I see him. On the
I
top.
Can. See, I see how they don't lose this battle, though.
Bally Wally. God.
Remember Anthony? Remember that guy?
Nah, bro. If Anthony was in this, I would have been like, nobody go in there. He would have just fucking ran in.
You fought the good fight, bud. Come on.
Bro, spawning in more boys. Fucking...
All right, pal. You're over.
Okay,
oh, three. There it is.
Goodbye, buddy. The strategy did seem a little cheesy, so we made sure to go back in and finish off all the stragglers. Yurgir was next on our hit list, and we sent Kelvin and their busted charisma stat forward to talk to him. Get rid of the fucking followers. Kill them motherfuckers first.
The Maragons. They barely have a thought to share among
themselves. The Maragons we can use for bombs, by the way.
They do have ears. Kill yourselves. Back to the Herald with you. Kill Nessa.
Oh.
They love each other. Stay it's really unfortunate. Still.
My beauty.
Oh my god. 22.
If you're wrong about this.
Ah, he's dead. We were able to finish off all the remaining Shaar trials, and we all headed down to go free the Night Song. Without Balthazar and his many minions, the cutscene went quite well. But we were met with an angry Shadowheart outside, and she decided she would leave the party for good. For someone who was still level 1 and had been chilling at our camp this whole time while we did all the work, she had quite a nasty attitude.
Tell bye.
Forget me like you did all your memories.
Oh. Some of us were sad to see her go because that meant we couldn't romance her. But I, on the other hand, had my sights set on someone else at our camp.
The timelessness of lovers.
You wish this was
the most beautiful fantasies.
Shut the frick up, man. Shut the frick up. I don't even care.
What are we thinking, bro? I'm like texting the group chat what I should say.
Hold on, sorry. Let me tune in.
I'm not carrying this.
Indeed.
Why has he got puppy dog eyes? Oh my god, I'm so in! Yo,
bro just wants to pee in your butt.
Whoa!
I'm sorry.
It's private?
Sorry,
what happened?
Sorry, y'all ain't gonna see that.
No! I wanna see it! No way.
Oh, welcome back.
I've never wanted to watch gay sex so much in my life.
And you're a bad liar. Yes?
How do you know what's about to happen, Aiden? You seen this?
Aiden wrote this.
Why is he so quiet?
You and I.
What? You haven't watched these all before?
No.
Dude, these are on YouTube.
Paintings.
Why are you watching the Gale
one? I'm not gonna do it in game.
Spines of a thousand books.
Oh. Oh.
Hey!
Yo. What are you?
Whose microphone is screaming?
Let me back in!
No way, this is not sex. Where's the sex?
Why confine ourselves to the pleasures of mortal flesh?
No way, bro. It's making me read a book.
Tapestry. Yeah, this is lame.
Oh my god, my dick!
I don't like this one.
Oh my god!
Gale, I'm gonna be honest. Countless ways to declare love. This is not really Gale,
you're doing too much.
After my super, super private night with Gale, our party set off to Moonrise Towers to finally begin the final battle.
Go!
All right.
Wait.
Bro's got ready. Are we ready?
Wait,
ready?
Okay. Brett. Summon in the dog. He's gotta be here for this.
Scratch.
Where I go? I don't know why you think you caught her.
Where I go?
So let me think. So there's gonna be a lot of people inside of there. Is there any way you can get to the fucking rafters, maybe? We get you up top?
Alright, I'm gonna shoot this big bitch.
Shoot.
I'm here. We're live.
Alright,
here. Me and dead right, fucking we're in. Last.
If anything, I'm gonna, like, Good shit, fuck. If you kill Lincella, I think the domination breaks on the two.
I could, what is it called?
I'm gonna try and milk them out.
Oh, perfect!
Oh my god, she
fucking pussy! Killed.
Don't even use a spell slot then if it's only four, I guess.
I just hit it though.
You got nade.
What? Wait, what?
Death ward.
Ah, shit.
It's like the spell version of your relentless endurance.
Okay, gang.
Right, guys, get don't slip.
Let's go.
Oh, yeah, we are 400 XP from fucking leveling up.
We're gonna get it. Nice.
Let's fucking go. Parasite in that
corpse. Oh my god, I can't wait to take my one level one fighter.
When are you it's doing that? So
right now.
Really?
Yeah.
I leveled up.
What are you taking fighter for?
Oh, I just accidentally clicked the door. Surge. I just clicked the door.
Why did you click the door? What does it say? Oh my god, he's up there. What the fuck? Why did you do this?
Yeah, and you're okay. It's fine because Aiden is also a persuasion.
Yeah, I am actually good.
Or is a charisma.
I have person. Plus +7 on this.
Okay, we can. Yeah, yes, it's fine. I should be up here with you.
Okay. So, do you want me to do it right now?
Yes.
What is going on right now? I have no clue what's happening.
So I came up here and I binked the check.
They can just move around?
Do not fucking sneak attack Dame Aiden.
Don't do anything, Anthony.
She's on our side!
How do you know that?
She's green.
We just freed her.
She's green.
Why would you show trust mercy this bitch.
Don't do anything stupid, okay?
No.
Oh, I just can't bink this.
What is it?
Plus 30? 30 difficulty class?
Oh, it had to be a crit.
No, you roll 20.
I can only get a 27.
No, if you roll a 20...
It's a crit. It's a critical success.
Guess we're fighting.
How's it that time?
We are about to get into a fight.
Anthony, just listen. Just listen, please.
It's about to be game time. I need you to be in.
Oh my god, fine.
Like, you have, like, 2 seconds.
I know nothing about his legendary action. Hold on.
Okay. Enough. Shoot him now.
This ends.
Now?
Crumble at the power of your touch. Shoot him. Give shoot him. Shoot Kefir.
Okay. Listen to him, Aelin!
No.
Oh, okay, it showed damage on her, and I almost shit myself. Man. It showed damage on her, and almost, I almost shit myself. I need you to...
Way to do this.
How did that still miss? I have fucking 88 fucking precision attack on my cock. Like, fuck you, buddy.
It's chill.
I'm gonna have a stroke. I'm gonna have a stroke.
It's still very winnable.
Fuck you. Wish I had that cape.
I mean, Kether's already half health. Okay, Dame.
Fucking level 5 nice. Ranger, level 3 Rogue, level 1 Fighter, level 7 Bard, level 2 Wizard, level 9 Fighter, level 9 Paladin. I can't do it all.
Brett, I think you're just pop a potion and pray. That's gonna be... Maybe kill the dog. Because you probably can't kill... You can't kill Kether on your turn.
I don't need a full kill.
I think you just go.
Come on, man. It's like 45.
I mean, you've done your turn pretty good. You've hit him for like 100 and something.
I ain't finished playing just yet.
I'm cleaving.
Nice.
Oh, there it is.
There we go.
Thank God, I did my work. We followed Kethric down into the mysterious tube. And down there, Aiden was able to get the summon for us. The cute little brain dude from the Nautiloid. We had hit level 9 during the Battle of Moonrise, so that calmed our nerves about this upcoming fight slightly. With some smoke powder barrels in hand, the four of us prepared to head into the first battle of the run, in which we had no means of escape.
Why am I invisible?
I
can jump all the way to the cage right now.
I can't see.
Free the bitch!
What am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to kill this cracker?
In a second.
Wait. Okay.
Alright, she's free.
Anthony, okay. I think you kill the Mind Flayer first. Actually, you know what?
I can go fight Kethric. Well, I guess the second he dies.
I can take care of Mr. Mind Flayer next turn. Yeah. Jump up there.
Now he has a legendary action on Anthony.
Yep.
Kethric can Horde Strike.
I mean, I can basically heal myself the full next turn and then hit him.
All right, us is going for the ones, bro. He's taking on the fucking the gang over here.
Get it, us! Get it, us! I have a 4% chance to shoot. Fuck,
dude!
Right.
Don't forget about Thrax, though.
Yeah, the two gang members about to go in. They're taking on the little boys for us.
Got your back, gang. Oh shit, wait, 17 damage?
Yo, bring him over here, bro.
That's crazy.
Bring him with the shit squad.
Dude, wait till Connor pulls up, bro.
Oh fuck, this motherfucker with the shit.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Wait.
Sorry, I'd rather where are you going? Over there.
Overcome!
Oh.
Wait, 4% of hit's gonna be crazy. I bink these, bro.
Damn, you were close, though.
Wait, need 22 to hit. If I just give you a...
Oh, he's dead.
Oh, nice.
I'm fucking 20! Actually, okay, it works. It works how I think it works.
Okay, this is the scary part.
It's okay, he's got a big hitbox. 390!
He does the fucking crit... Okay, what is his legendary action?
Legendary action. Mirko can use Gaze of the Dead on the first creature that strikes at each round of combat. Oh, okay.
Not it.
Brett, that's gotta be you because you have the necrotic resistance.
Wait, real?
It has to be you. You have to be first strike.
Hey, I'm gonna stand on the opposite to his left.
I'm getting precise.
Let Brett hit first.
Can I just attack? Oh shit, I didn't hit attack. First, nothing.
I rolled a 30? That did nothing. Holy fuck, that did nothing.
Okay.
Which one should I use? Use the bardic first, because Indomitable is just a reroll.
That was bad.
I'm just trying to think. Yeah, I can drop my bomb bag here.
I think if you guys can get ready to start burning down those necromites, and just like find ways to, like, even if it means passing around bombs and throwing them to get rid of the skeleton invokers, because like. We don't. If he starts eating necromites, he's just gonna.
You can hit him now if you can.
He's gonna be restoring damage.
I can't hit.
Hey, let's just.
Sister. Hey.
That one you can indomitable. Fuck.
Okay, that's not bad.
That's not bad.
Yeah.
Oh, here it is.
Yeah.
Wait.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to take that.
How low are you right now?
44.
I might be at.
Well, dude, okay. I have a nat 1 right now. I could make this miss, but that's my last port and die.
I mean, I'd love you.
I just like.
I can take it, partially.
I mean, Dame Aelin should come up here.
True. I think honestly, it's worth to use now. But if you want to save it, we can.
Have Scratch bite
just bite these fucking things.
Yeah, in. Just yeah. Break invokers. We don't want any more of these things spawning. The
don't drop the bomb on
invokers.
Top of Dame Aelin, though.
The bomb's right. No, do you see the bomb? No, there's a backpack. Right. Your fire elemental might get exploded.
That's fine.
Next time that hits.
That was
like 100 damage.
That was decent.
Legit. And now the fire stays up, and I go this way.
Oh, dude, that dude fucked everyone. All those dice up there. I love that from the girl. Oh, don't love that from her.
Well, she ate the legendary action, sweet.
She can't die, right? Like, if
no,
she doesn't die, but like she goes down.
It's like, that's. Oh god.
Better her than me, I always say.
Oh, this is not good.
I can hit the smoke powder barrel if y'all can dip, because I can.
No. Hello, bro. That's it. Fucking shit. Oh, wait, no, I'm scared now. Uh oh, I can't move.
Uh oh.
If I sound the horn.
Oh my god. He's so much health still.
We just need. I think we gotta keep popping these. These invoker things.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's the plan.
The fortunate thing is I'm like frightened for 2 turns. I'm kind of stuck here, right next to the barrel I put down.
He's definitely gonna hit you. Thank you. You might want to stop this from happening, Kelvin. Cutting words, this please. Kelvin. Oh.
That
set up the smoke
powder
barrel. Yeah.
Why did I not blow up then? Why do I?
It did.
Nobody.
I think you made the deck save.
You just survived. You ate it.
God, dude is giggling at me. Wait, she's down there. She's down there.
Yeah.
He killed a healer ass.
Yeah.
Bring her home.
She's back, baby.
Dame Aelin, boss the fuck up!
She's got only fucking issue 5 hit points.
Yeah, she has 5
health.
She's
about to go right back up there, holy shit. Yeah, we got her for 1 turn.
Yeah. Okay.
I need you to boss the fuck up!
Why did she go up?
What do you mean you weren't escaping me? You did nothing! Did it already use its Gaze of the Dead?
I don't know.
I don't think I want to hit him this time.
It's each creature that strikes it.
I don't know.
Fuck, I don't know if Fireball counts as a strike.
To find out, huh?
Okay, I can wait. Okay, next turn I can put up another wall of fire. It's fine.
Yeah, we're chilling.
Okay.
Wait, what?
Oh, she can.
She comes back. Bitch.
Oh.
I said what I said.
I can shoot Merkel if you need.
I have a bomb. I don't think I can throw it that far though.
Aiden, have you gone down yet?
Yeah. I can throw this shit up. Wait.
I have gone down.
At him?
If I hover over and point it at him, it says 25%. What if I just, like, throw it at the ground next to him? Like, I don't... Like, what's the...
If you throw it at the ground next to him, I can set it on fire.
I think it implodes on impact.
Oh.
See what happens. Oh, I love that.
That's pretty good.
Wait.
Oh, let's my god.
Go. Can I get a rebuy?
Oh my god, it looks so epic. Holy shit. Cool ass cape.
I'm just dead.
Alright, it's a canon event.
Can I get a revive?
One Infinity Stone in hand, we met up with all our friends in the lobby after our victory, before we set off to leave Act 2 behind. In comparison to Act 1, Act 2 seemed to go by a lot easier. There were no moments where I thought we were in completely over our heads. But we were in for a rude awakening when we reached the city of Baldur's Gate. Leaving the Shadow Curse lands behind, our party enjoyed a nice night off in camp, until some Githyanki ambushed us. So, we hurried through the portal to assist our dream visitor.
Is it just like me? Am I the is it the same person?
I don't know. It's fine.
Oh my god. Yeah.
It's just weird how you're talking about it.
No, not a joke. Okay, yep, I just killed everybody.
I think he was just saying you were, like, making it weird.
Yeah, you're making it kind of weird, Anthony.
Oh, I'm in a cutscene.
We'll never know if Kelvin lived.
I'm also in a cutscene.
Oh, Anthony's there.
But I'm drifting through astral space.
Why are there so many monks here?
Don't let my form deceive.
Oh wow, that's why you said it.
Anthony!
Anthony, I'm dogging them things.
Anthony, you're down?
I'm slanging them dangins.
We decided to trust the Emperor for now. But it did pay me to see my Lord and Savior Orpheus all chained up. The Emperor offered us a special tadpole that would enhance our abilities. Throughout the run, all of us had been squeezing as many tadpoles as we could find into our eyes for some extra power, and I decided to take the Emperor up on his offer. Although it made me significantly uglier, the power of flight alone made it worth it. Kelvin also decided to use a tadpole, and I wanted everyone else to use it too, but Kelvin ate the tadpole instead of just opening their mind to it, so Aiden and Anthony did not get to use it. Anthony didn't really want to use it anyway, because he didn't want to damage his already extremely great looks. We made our way down to Raphael, and I decided that we would accept his deal for the hammer. We wanted to side with Orpheus later, and we did not intend to fight Raphael, so it seemed like the best option. However unfortunate it was to have Raphael in possession of our souls. We also met up with our good buddy Barkus, and his asshat of a friend Wolbrin. Wolbrin tasked us with a job to blow up the Steel Watch. We said yes, but only so we could get his bomb so we could use it later on something else. After completing a couple more side quests, we headed towards the city. We visited Gortash at his coronation, and I decided we would accept his offer of an alliance. Except I actually intended for us to stay true to it, so we could skip one of the main boss fights against him later. With that out of the way, we finally actually entered the city of Baldur's Gate. Our first order of business in the city was to stop some serial killer, and we also visited the Emperor's secret hideout after killing a bunch of rats. Our first big fight was in the Murder Tribunal, where Kelvin had an interesting strategy.
Oh my god, dude.
Yo, shut up.
I'm just saying it's so stupid how it works. It's so annoying.
I'm just saying, I don't know if we need to see every single one.
I don't know why it gives it to all of you. Would fucking, I guess it has to.
I'm like, I don't need to see the port and dice thing every time.
Hey, look.
Bro, I just saw the arrow go by during the cutscene. This guy's got level 16, by the way. Oh, he's got a legendary action. That would have been nice to know.
What is the AC?
These things are buffs. These things, killing these things buffs him.
Oh. What do I want me to do? Not kill him?
Well, no. Killing this one, killing this one is actually huge.
Okay. Well,
I'm gonna.
That's all I can do to him. He's very low, though.
I'm gonna try and kill that one then. Fuck it.
Oh, hear me out.
His attacks now heal him for that much. What? Mother. That's not what it said on the fucking... Okay. That's different.
Yeah, I gotta turn off,
I gotta figure something out for this fight.
Interesting.
The last one.
Should I not shoot this guy, or...
he doesn't have his... I don't know if he has his legendary action anymore, but... After performing 4 attacks, Saravak will have embodied enough. I don't know. Okay, wait. I think that just means he has another counter before he has enough to do the thing. So I think you're fine.
Huge damage from the kid. Love that from you.
So the thing is, this thing isn't it like?
Oh, critical miss.
Could be bad, right? His. Yeah. Every time you hit him, it brings him closer to his thing. So don't you want to hit him for a lot?
All right, we gotta keep. Wait, if we break her concentration, he gets lethargic.
Yeah.
So if you can't hit her, fuck.
I can kill her, basically.
Try to break her concentration, but not kill her, maybe, because if she dies... If she dies, he gets hasted permanently.
Okay, I don't think this should kill her.
Okay, perfect.
I thought you killed her. I really thought you killed her.
I'd be surprised.
Wait, he's not lethargic. Never mind. Oh my god.
She ain't dead though.
She ain't dead yet.
Nice.
Okay. All crits.
I'm gonna beat the shit out
of
him?
Yeah. I think we just try and beat the shit out of him.
Run us. No, dude, this fucking ice,
fucking
dude.
Way.
I knew it was gonna happen too. I knew it was gonna happen when I flew over, but this fucking elephant. That's huge. I would have cooked his ass so hard.
Fuck, dude. Okay, he's still in it. I think now we can kill her safely.
Okay. Please.
Wait.
Why did you stop countering?
I didn't stop concentrating.
Okay, your turn.
Can't be paralyzed, restrained, or have his movement.
Maybe we shouldn't have killed him.
Oh my god! It wasn't just haste. Okay.
So we cannot hold this person anymore?
I cannot hold this person anymore.
Well, he's hitting it! Bro is actually hitting this shit. Oh my god.
What the fuck am I looking at?
Yeah, what the fuck?
Bro is fucking emoting. He's doing the boogie down emote.
It says he can't move or take action.
Let's find out.
Oh.
No way, he kicked buddy.
That's it? That's huge. I'm watching this dude dance.
Straight jorking it.
Imagine
if that's what he's doing. He's doing the jerk.
I just love the fucking mirror images are hitting that shit too.
Be respectful.
He's at 22, bro. Yo, this dancing shit saved this guy. I'm not gonna lie.
I gotta buy the scroll.
I have another one.
The dancing dude go crazy. We love the. Oh my god, so much XP.
Gaming.
We also helped Dame Aelin destroy a wizard who had been hunting her, securing her as an ally in the battles to come. After that fight, we decided it was time to take a nice long rest. Holy shit, the Emperor is shirtless.
This is so.
Yo, Anthony, you see this?
Fuck yeah.
Sometimes.
Oh, I felt almost oh like it's we game time.
Oh, it's game time. Something deeper.
Would you like that?
Oh, he said, would you like that? Very much. It's for the achievement, guys. The back of your mind warms with a
rush of feeling. Is everybody about to fuck this guy?
Mm-hmm. Heat.
It's game time.
Oh my god, I got the fucking...
So did I.
Wait, this bitch is kind of bad. Why would I say no to this?
I think I'm fucking no, it as a kid. I don't think I did it right.
You fucked him as a squid?
Yeah, I don't. How'd you change it over?
I said, he said, I can make it easier. I said, please do.
Following our interesting night out with the Emperor, Anthony was still not satisfied that he hadn't gotten with anyone besides a squid the entire playthrough. Kelvin had Minthara, I had Gale, but Anthony was still seeking some sort of connection. So, we decided to go on a bit of a field trip.
I don't already know where to go.
Bye, good luck, buddy.
What happens if you find your dad? Hey, Anthony.
Hey. Imagine we steal the cutscene, though.
I guess, it's the first time.
Yeah, that's, hey. Shh, over here.
Better be cautious.
He's talking.
Oh, y'all have to leave or she won't let me do it.
God damn it. Oh, shitty ass game mechanic. Oh my god, he's gonna kill her.
He can stay.
No, close the door.
Right now.
Okay, it works with Connor.
You got it, buddy. Good luck.
Again. Wait, yeah, I just lost him.
What? Dude, I'm in combat with her!
She's
what?
She got...
Maybe just knock her out.
She got me.
Knock her out, and next long rest will come back.
Y'all are always cock-blocking, dude.
At this point in the game, we were all very geared, but there were still a couple of items we wanted. But they were both located in Raphael's domain, the House of Hope. After doing some quick Googling, Kelvin and I found out it was possible to steal these items without fighting Raphael, as long as we didn't trigger the alarm. So, with nobody else online, Kelvin and I ventured into the House of Hope to pull off a heist.
Okay, so I'm gonna cast the darkness.
Maybe do it from like a hiding spot so we don't see you cast it, I don't know.
This guy down here.
Oh yeah, I put that up.
That should be the same weight as the gloves. So I think if you throw it up there, I'm gonna cast, and then you're gonna throw it up there.
Okay.
And then, or don't throw, I mean, not like throw it, but like click, like drag click it up there.
Wait, where the hell did this go?
You hide it? Okay.
Bye-bye.
Okay, where are I think it's up there.
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay. Alright. Now you two start leaving. I think like really, really start leaving.
Why?
Because I think they might get really pissed off.
But the and then thing I need over there.
I need to
Nobody's angry.
I know, but I need to be the closest one to I think the archivist when we leave turn-based mode.
Time to rest.
Alright.
Wait, turn-based mode first?
Hang on. Yeah, turn-based mode first. Wait, what?
Turn-based mode. What just happened? Are we good?
Oh, no.
Who's laughing? What'd you just do? Jib. Where did everybody go, though?
I have no... Wait. We're not disguised anymore.
Are we not?
No one but you will ever believe this. Fuck.
Alright, I just turn my smoke, see what happens.
I'm gonna throw up.
Light on my feet.
There's a fight outside.
Oh, okay.
There is, in fact, a fight outside. Okay,
Oh,
Wait, it hasn't saved, right?
I mean, it hasn't saved.
Go around any.
Where's our last save at?
Oh, whenever I close the game saves.
I'm gonna throw up, dude. I'm feeling the honor mode. Okay. We need to get. Oh my god,
I'm gonna throw up.
I'm gonna throw up, man. Well, okay, wait. Because now does this count as us having broken the contract?
I don't know. With the alarm set off, we were put in a very scary situation. We had not planned to fight Raphael on this run, and we came into the House of Hope underprepared. While freeing Hope, our party finally hit the max level, but we were still scared of the fight to come. Regardless, there was only one way out. So, we gathered the troops and prepared for our hardest battle yet.
Their skulls will make fine trophies.
Oh. It's coming up roses, boys.
Oh, dude, I don't even see the
monkey,
roll.
Monkey!
Bang! I'm assuming that's good. I don't see anything, but I'm assuming.
It's a 31. Okay. It's a 31.
He's with us, Aiden.
That takes courage.
Thank God.
How it is a very tiresome. If you have any last words, make it quick. It will only take a moment to finish you.
Okay. Connor, I'll fix Connor's here.
Oh, okay, wait. I go pretty early. Wait! Jarkir has his legendary action! Holy shit!
Wait.
Once per round, Jarkir can strike a hunted creature when it attempts to attack or cast a spell, dealing 5 to 50 radiant damage and possibly blinding the target.
Chill out. What you need from me, boss?
What's your plan?
What do you want me to do? I'll buy a pillar. I didn't equip the hammer because you said you could fucking...
No, that's okay. I honestly... If you wanna, like, if you wanna take some ones and start tripping motherfuckers just to, like, eat up basically, like, turn economy, or if you wanna start getting weapons out of hands,
weapons out of hands.
Yeah, feel free, because their weapon attacks deal, like, another 3d6 if they're near Raphael. Alright, I'm gonna break that pillar next to you.
Good damage.
Oh my god, kill us.
Raphael has consumed the power of a destroy spell. He's unable to cast spells using souls until he transforms into the Ascended Fiend. Okay, but he needs to transform. Holy shit!
He fell!
Better! I'm better!
You're already down 60.
I'm better!
Yeah, but he's gonna heal, I think.
Hurt this guy. Oh my god! Dude, Anthony's a demon right now.
Wait, you're just trying to fucking... Oh, throw his head. What are you doing over here?
Oh, my god!
Your gear. Bigly.
You're him, more like it.
I think I just destroyed another tower.
Yeah.
Wait! I don't have the spell anymore?
Oh.
Why not?
What spell?
Oh, wait, hold on. Wait, please. No... I don't have it, so I'm just gonna have to go for him.
Bruh, I think it's gonna just be you with the hammer.
I didn't equip the hammer because Kellen's and Luke can destroy fucking half the things, but
it happened.
I mean, we can still get. I think we can still get through these.
I can still equip the hammer if I need to, or I could go for the cambions. Okay. If I equip the hammer, that's an action, right? And I can't attack. But can I action surge?
You can action surge after that, yeah.
I could definitely take out one of the towers in one turn then.
So do you want me to just
waste the die to hit him? How low is this
champions?
I could just attack him right now.
That merc is goofy, yeah.
Oh my god! Jesus!
Oh my god!
Fucking Christ!
Wait, okay. Fuck. Okay, that's the soul ascension thing. Wait, how is he still able to? It's a legendary action. Okay, I guess. Whatever. Anthony's just got to take a hit.
You ain't got him a bonus action?
Holy fuck.
Hey, that's why we got hope. That's why we pay her the big bucks.
Yep, I'm going. Oh, fuck. Wait, Raphael breaks from this shit.
Try me.
At the end of his turn. So he's still gonna heal. Or he's not gonna get a turn, but he's still gonna get out.
Nice.
Huge. Okay.
You got a potion for it? You got a potion?
Apparently I don't have a bonus action.
Yeah, we just survive. Still Hope's turn.
Okay. Sure.
Okay.
The thingy?
In front of me?
They also have the reflection thing.
Can I hit somebody without getting nuked?
No.
I will get nuked if I hit somebody?
You will, yes.
If you just use all your actions on moving here.
Oh wow, it is only 49%.
Oh dude. That's easy.
You don't like those odds?
Oh wait, I can autos him again. Actually, no, I like those odds.
That's what I'm talking about! I don't know if we were breaking this thing.
Holy yowza. I can hit it with a force arrow of Anthony's.
I guess
he's just gonna have to. Okay. Can you jump away?
I can hit it again.
Break it, I guess. I can try and fight the Cambion that's on. Oh.
Where do you want me to go now?
Raphael? I see.
Yeah, you're gonna help Shorty Hope.
I mean, Austin's about to be there, dude.
Oh. Cool. Alright. She's good. Because then you can, like, preserve life and then cure wounds or whatever.
Oh, he's doing the thing.
Oh, shit. Well, you. Oh, okay. Huge. Oh. Yeah, Aiden just eats those. Okay.
Oh, I was there too.
Yeah.
What?
Your toe.
Oh, you both ate fucking. Jesus Christ.
His toe got hit.
I don't know if the circle continues to do damage, but I guess.
I can't really actually have provoke opportunity. Dude, imagine if Connor was here, though.
Oh, dude, Connor solos.
I mean, us is putting that work. I think he's done, like, 18 damage this whole time.
Rogers
hasn't
been hit. He's been chilling.
He also isn't 18.
It didn't burn the die, though, did it?
Oh, hey, he just took that damage. Oh, my God.
Maybe this circle is bad. Yeah. If you can try and attack him from, like, the... Give him some back shots, maybe?
I mean,
yeah.
We can just hit him and then walk out.
Yeah, I've got one dice left. I mean, it's 100% chance to hit him. Oh my god, just walking into it.
Yeah, it's free crits currently. But,
yeah, walking into that thing just fucked my health.
Oh, fucking Christ.
Maybe it's bow time. Tony.
Oh wait, Anthony has the Scroll of Sunbeam.
Oh my god.
Is it him?
He actually showed up.
Get him in!
Please.
Get in for the last, like, fucking 20 minutes that I have.
It's over. 20 minutes? You're just gonna leave us?
I have to go to... I have to help with bedtime.
We'll be done soon.
Kids don't know how to sleep.
You don't understand how much prep we were doing.
I mean, you're fighting fucking Raphael here. I think y'all were gonna go crazy without me. That's fucked up.
Honestly, neither did we, Big Dog.
you know what I mean?
Thought we were just gonna go do the one, like, go free hope real quick. And then Aiden and Kelvin are like, all right, let's get prepped. I'm like, all right, I guess we're doing this. Fuck.
Is this my armor?
It might be
my
armor. Best.
My brother in Christ, yes. The only thing I swapped was your gloves to give you higher dex. Which, never mind.
Shut up about the fucking gloves. I wear
them
all the time.
Yo.
I wear them all the time. I bought them for a reason.
Yo. I'm not just gonna sit here and get lied to.
I take them off. I switch them out when I need to fucking pick a lock. I don't know what the fuck to tell you, dude.
You're here.
Oh my god.
Bang. Last thing I did.
That's crazy.
Oh.
Ravaging
oh
Inferno.
My god.
Oh my god.
You ain't got a counter spell that'll fucking beat that, I don't think.
Wait, who does that hit?
I don't know.
Looks like me, probably.
I think that just hits you and the Air Myrmidon.
I think I can take it.
Okay, do you have your absorb elements?
Yeah. Oh, doesn't even give me that. Dude, you guys stand him right here. Look at this trifecta. No soul is in good hands. Holy shit.
Oh my god, the gangbang is here.
Beat his ass! Beat his ass!
It would have been cool though.
Wait.
I don't think we need to overthink this. He's got 19 health.
General,
we are
Black is fucking nuts.
Let's go!
Fuck you, yeah,
Grab his shit!
We all collectively exhaled after winning, and Aiden was happy to steal the Helldusk armor off of Raphael's corpse as a trophy. At this point, there was only one item left that we really wanted, the Giant Slayer you get from killing Ansur. After defeating Raphael, we strode into the Dragon's Den with confidence. But we had no idea what we were walking into.
I am the one who roars! This time, you will not escape it!
Oh my god, I look so cool. Oh hey guys, I'm inside of him.
I love being inside of him.
Jesus!
Yeah.
Huh.
Fuck yeah, I'm gonna do it again.
Well, he doesn't have his legendary action anymore, so you're good. Spork is dead.
Spork is dead.
Spork just blew up.
Not
dead. No, you're good. Honestly, Fork is usually just the most like non-factor, so it's completely fine. If you want to do that again, my ghouls will be a big explosion near him, but I don't know if he takes the- Yeah, he doesn't- Oh, he's resistant to necrotic, so it'll just be a little less. Okay, strength drain. What am I, squid long?
We did some damage to him, Anthony. We did some damage to him.
Oh, I'm not done.
Oh wait, okay. Wait. This is like the...
I don't like this.
Yeah, gathering energy while airborne and is resistant to all damage. So... Okay, I think we just need to like get the fuck out of here.
Hide behind the little pillars.
Yeah. And then we can slowly start dealing with the Myrmidons as this happens. But yeah, Ansur's ire will get you killed. All right, bye Myrmidon. By us. Anthony's gone. Anthony exploded.
Oh, Anthony. What are those things? All right.
Lightning strikes.
So you have to move out of the way before they get me?
Yeah, probably.
I got 3 spell slots left. I'm down to use one of the last 3.
Your dex is poopy!
Dude, this guy sucks.
I don't have Fireball up right now, but...
This is my last spell slot, better hit. Okay, back! Oh. Wait.
He has a phase too.
Oh,
where are we supposed to go?
Wait.
Oh, this is bad.
Wait, his fucking turn...
We have... Begin targeting energy, gain turn, and lose all capacity. Okay, he still has 2 turns. Up towards the front, maybe? Just get out. I think just trying to get out
of. Is his turn like right now? Is he just gonna fucking blow up?
No, I think. No, I think we have. So I think we have 2 turns.
You delicious bitch. Am I that movie, Brett?
No. Right. Oh Jesus.
Oh, I'm alive though. I thank God for my ability. Thank God for me, right? This is what we call a run killer.
Holy fuck, dude.
Oh, hey, Aiden.
I can just hit him.
Four health total.
I could just hit him.
Run.
Right? Or does he,
Well, he has his shit that hits you back, but, like, if you kill him, I don't think...
Okay. I don't know if legendary actions proc...
I do.
I think...
Well...
I don't know.
I feel like Aiden could just kill him.
I don't think he can do the report attack if I kill him.
Yeah, but can you 100% guarantee a hit?
Yeah, hear me out.
I can 100%. I also could just drink a potion. I got high AC. I think I could take a hit.
It's about dex saving. But
also, don't stand in a lightning strike.
All I'm saying is I could just walk up to him and fucking kill him.
So walk around him, like, to be, like, out of that lightning strike. Or actually, no, if you walk up to him, you'll be out of the lightning strike.
You'll pop
okay,
first.
Use the biggest one of the healers.
I have a big one in my inventory, the 30 to 60.
And then I would say just swing on him. Fuck me, dude.
Oh, Aiden's got 50 health? Oh, he's free.
91% chance of hitting?
That's
game.
God! Oh my god, we almost lost the run.
I'm gonna go get him.
It's just paladin, dude. I got that shit that like I got my sword.
1 hit point. That is what stood between us and losing the run. If Aiden had not chosen to play as a half-orc, he wouldn't have had relentless endurance, and the run would have ended right then and there. Fortunately, the gods were on our side that day, and we were able to make it out alive. With that battle out of the way, we finally decided to go face Orin, who had kidnapped Lazelle earlier. After facing 2 hard fights with the Raphael and Ansur one, Orin proved to be an easy opponent in comparison. Although Anthony did accidentally let Lazelle die, which was a little unfortunate. We had finally reached the final stretch. Earlier, Hel and I had gone around doing some side missions to grant us as many allies as we could without breaking our deal with Gortash. We all stocked up on potions, scrolls, and arrows, then headed into the talk with Gortash.
I'm gonna swap it back though.
Yeah, you're ugly.
I'm about 90% sure it's number 2. That will, yeah.
I'm here for games. Hand me the stones, or face the black hand of...
This is... Trust me. Just trust me, alright? This doesn't seem like the right option. But...
I was merely testing you. This should be an alliance of peers.
Mortash led us to the Brain, where we were ready to finally take it on.
I'm glad we got this guy as our ally, though. You know, he's gonna help.
Die.
Oh
no,
gang! How many what are we thinking?
Well, I think wisdom,
I'm a strong guy. Well, shit. You can roll a nat 20 into the critical success, but it still doesn't do anything.
Did I? When I first saw that first roll do nothing, like he just ate it, I knew something was up. Oh.
What just happened?
I don't know. I heard Connor die. Is that the Emperor?
I pulled you out just in time. The situation is worse than I thought.
Is this the guy we all fucked?
Wait, are we getting Orpheus out? Free my boy?
Wait.
Free Luff.
Dude, that's the savior of my people right there, Orpheus. He's gonna save me. Lazelle would have loved him. If she only saw him.
I have assessed our encounter.
Oh my god. Did anybody else see Kelvin just spawn it? I think he just walked through me.
Yeah. Little scuff.
Man, fuck you.
Give the stones to me. I will assimilate Orpheus. And then I will...
He's gonna eat Orpheus? Bro, that's my guy. I fuck with him.
You're a good Yankee, you can't do that. You gotta free Orpheus.
There is another.
You still don't trust me.
Fuck now. Anthony, what do you think? You fuck with him?
I encouraged you to fulfill your potential. All while protecting you from harm.
He looks kinda ugly.
What I truly am.
Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. You enjoyed me. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, that was just like a... just for the achievement.
Is this like a... is this like a yes or no? We choose to like trust this guy or not?
Yeah.
Oh.
Or...
after everything I've done for you.
Fuck you.
You leave me no option but to join the
Netherbrain. Ain't he kind of an op, bro?
What the fuck?
Guys, I know... where's my hammer? My king! My savior! Oh my god, look at us. Whoa, 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 whoa.
Why do you look like that?
Holy shit, he has the force. Dude. With a no.
How does he know?
No, no, I didn't. You slaughtered my honor guard. No, 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 no. Nonetheless. Oh, good.
How we know? It seems we must be allies. What? Did he watch us? May address me
as your majesty. I will.
I felt like he would have more of a dominating voice. Our common goal,
I would strangle you where you stand. He's just being a little silly.
Your very he sounds more like a bartender than a fucking king. At this point,
it will take an illithid to unleash
the full potential of the Netherstones. All I'm saying is you give that Netherbrain some a little bit of the ganja.
Guys.
Starts getting those crazy thoughts.
Do I turn him into a mind flayer? But that's my guy.
I'm not becoming a mind flayer.
Anthony, you'll become a mind flayer, right?
Do I gotta?
You can keep the green hair.
I guess it's decided. I'll do what I must. It seems I misjudged you.
You are capable of no.
My friends, it has been an honor serving
you
with you.
If you get an option to decline, I'll do it. The voice of the
absolute out, it's too late now. But just as I can raise them, I must do what I have to. I'd say build a statue of me, but...
where'd your cock go?
So, Olaf the Githyanki was no more, replaced by an ugly-looking mind flayer. We headed out with Orpheus into the final battlegrounds, where one way or another, our journey would reach its end. We either get the golden dice, or we're gonna be going to bed a little upset.
Die trying.
It is what it is.
Mine's kind of a bad
Avengers.
Idea.
All right, I'm gonna fly him out to try and eat the Draconic
so,
Fury.
Is call allies, is that a bonus action?
No, that's a main action. That's a
okay.
Action.
Can you guys summon people in? I just can't fucking click anything. I click on it and then nothing happens after. Apparently I can't do it as a mind flayer because I don't have a mouth. Alright, somebody's gotta start summoning people in.
I got
I mean I got a mouth.
Fucking really.
Cause the thing is we don't even have to kill all these people. We just need to get to that back platform. I'm trying to get Orpheus there and me there.
Yeah, I'm just trying to trip these bitches.
Yeah, summon some bitches in, bro.
Who you want me to call in?
Do the fucking just any of them at this point.
Bro, you have a mouth, dog. Hello, what's this? Oh wait, I'm controlling him?
Oh really?
Shit. Are you? That's crazy.
If you want to move him up top to like the mind flayers, if you can.
Oh, that worked well.
Love that. Love that from you.
Oh, I kind of, I might actually get on the dragon, because I will do Luko damage to him.
Weak grip. What about weak grip?
European.
My grip ain't weak, bro.
Damn. Oh,
I killed another mind flayer.
Did I attack the dragon?
You want to?
It's not super.
We really don't have to kill him. I mean, you're gonna want to start moving this way, because once I get the Glove of Invulnerability down, we can go through this portal.
Okay.
And we only have us, like, it might be 4 or 5 turns to kill the brain before all the platforms are just gone. Oh my god, he's gone.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, RIP Demper. RIP Demper.
Fucking turn one.
Why did he do that shit in the Raphael fight, huh? That hurt.
Oh, y'all are really close. I don't know why I've never seen it do that.
Oh, he's dazed. Is Aiden? Oh, fuck.
Are we supposed to be over there?
We want to start getting close.
Fuck. I can help. I think I'm going to do that. Oh wait, that works.
None of those hit!
Yes, if you want to start moving over here, it'd be good. I'm starting the...
I'll really start trying, but...
If you want to just get in the globe...
I can do some damage.
To who? Though. I mean, if you want to clear the way a little bit for Calvin, it wouldn't be bad. Just the people who are up here.
Get this bitch out of here.
Chabert.
Get the fuck out.
Well, now she's just on top of Calvin. That's,
do not
that's great.
Put her near me, please.
That's great.
That's heat.
What a dumbass. What a dumbass.
God, I love AI. Oh, wait, no, because we need global vulnerability.
We need that.
Yeah. Do not shoot the brain until global vulnerability is done.
Yo, where the gang at?
I can come in.
Yeah,
it only brought you through though.
Should I? Which one's the bomb bag?
What am I supposed to do?
Oh my god, the bombs are out.
Do not shoot the big guy.
Oh, the room powder bomb's there. I see it.
I don't see a big guy.
I can go down there,
Aiden,
and I can drop some more things too, Calvin. I'm gonna do that.
Anthony, can you try and murderize this guy on the left? This mind flare on the to the south, the one with the blue circle at his feet.
I don't see any mind flare in here.
Okay, Anthony came inside. Anthony is just inside.
Oh, Aiden really told me to.
Okay. Breathe.
Okay, I did not say go in the portal.
So, I would, so...
You said, why aren't you in the portal? So I figured that meant go in the portal.
Wait, Anthony, is this still your turn?
I'll flip it.
No, just chill. Is this still your turn? Oh, why did he spawn over here? Anthony, can you get to Orpheus?
Orpheus?
Wait, I can hit a jump. I can hit a jump. Stay there.
I mean, like, probably.
You have a fire arrow?
Yeah, I got a fire arrow. I also got a smoke powder arrow.
Are you inside of this? Do we just bank it, Kelvin? We are inside the globe.
Honestly, go for it.
Do smoke powder.
Wait. There it is. Let's go. We did it. Let's go.
Wait, we beat the game.
We won. Bomb bag, baby.
Let's go. Hey, yo, boys. What's the strongest school of magic? Explodomancy, motherfucker.
Force Anthony Sin back with his bow gets the final shot of the run.
I mean, could it end any other way?
With the brain defeated, we commanded it to destroy itself, becoming the heroes of the gate.
My people will burn away Vlakith's corruption. And it is all thanks to you, the Illithid who defied a Netherbrain.
You
couldn't have done it alone, guys.
As you wish, my savior.
Exquisitine Biznips got you here.
Who's that? Is that that little guy who follows us around?
Exquisitine the ugly.
Yo.
Kelvin.
Yo.
Kelvin, I need you to listen to me.
Take your own life.
Kelvin.
What the fuck?
Kelvin.
I'm listening.
You take that egg. You sit on that thing. You hatch him. You name him Olaf the Second.
He will know his father.
I'd say make me a statue, but I already have one.
What are you doing? Stop!
Damn! After the death of Olaf, Langestine, Farquaad, and Exquisitine met up for one last hurrah with all the members of our camp. For we finally bid the Honor Run farewell. It took us about 2 months to finish the playthrough, and overall, it was a great success. We got our golden die, and the run had enough tension to keep us on our toes at all times. All I know is in 30 years when Baldur's Gate 4 comes out, Olaf II will be making his grand appearance. Thanks for watching.